Welcome, my dear students. So let's get down to our business. In this video, we will discuss about some concepts related to completion of a normed space and a new type of basis called Schroeder basis. So first, I think we will discuss about Schroeder basis. So, Schroeder basis consists of, it is similar to what a basis is, but the difference is it may contain infinitely many elements. So, it is related to the convergence of an arbitrary series in general. So, let's take a normed space, capital X. And for every element x in capital X, if there exists a sequence En, such that norm of x minus alpha 1 E1 plus alpha 2 E2 plus etc. alpha n en, where alpha 1, alpha 2, etc., alpha n are constants. This converges to 0 as n tends to infinity. So, which means that corresponding to every element in the normed space, there should exist a collection of vectors such that the linear combination of those vectors should approaches to the point as n tends to infinity. If at all such set of vectors exist, then we can say that this set of vectors En is called a Schroeder basis. Okay, so this is not in general the type of basis which we have defined in the earlier cases, in the case also of vector spaces. This is a basis which relates every element to a summation expression. So this says that this alpha 1 e1, alpha 2 e2, etc., alpha n en can be written as summation j is equal to 1 to n alpha j et, which says that this should go to x as n tends to infinity. So, in general, summation j is equal to 1 to infinity, alpha j ej should almost be x. This expression is the series expansion of the terms in general. So, this is what a Schroeder basis means. So, corresponding to every element in the normed space, if there exists a collection of vectors such that the series, a particular series expansion of that collection of vectors is approaching to the point which we have chosen for every point in the normed space, such type of vectors are called Schroeder basis. So please understand the fact that in general, not every normed space may have the Schroeder basis. Okay. So this is not something which is for every normed spaces. This is a particular thing which we can examine in the case of some particular set of normed spaces. Now it is quite natural to ask about what is the difference between a usual Schroeder basis and the usual basis. Okay. Since every normed space is a vector space, for every vector space we can define a basis. So what is the difference between these two bases? In the case of Schroeder basis, it can be observed that this number of elements in the space, in the basis, is always infinite. So it's a countable set in the case of Schroeder basis. But in the case of our usual basis, it may not be a countable set in general. So Schrödinger base in general is not always a finite set, but our bases can be a finite set. So that is the main difference between our usual basis and our Schrödinger basis. Okay, so another thing is, in the case of infinite dimensional spaces, usually the definition of basis is not enough to characterize or categorize the space in general, but the Schrödinger basis, which consists of infinitely many elements, can be used to help study an infinite dimensional spaces. Most of our spaces which we deal with in normed spaces are of infinite dimensional, as you have seen in the examples. So we need some definition of basis or some extension of basis which helps in studying an infinite dimensional space or normed space in general. So that's why we have defined this shorter basis as well. So let's move on to some examples. Consider the space LP. Okay. Here, take the element E n as delta nj. Okay, sequence delta nj, where if n is equal to j, it is 1. It is 0 if n not equal to j. So which means that actually E1 is consist of delta 1 1, delta 1 2, delta 1 3. I write it delta 1 1, delta 1 2, delta 1 3, delta 1 4, etc. Which is actually 1, since the index 1 and 1 are same. Since 1 and 2 are not same, it is 0, 0, 0, etc. And E2, similarly, delta 2, 1, delta 2, 2, etc. Which is actually 0, 1, 0, 0, etc. So E3, E4, etc. can be defined similarly. This collection of vectors is a Schrödinger basis in the case of LP. Okay, so this is an infinite collection of vectors. This is not a particular component. This is a sequence actually. Okay, this is a sequence which the nth element of the sequence is 1 if whenever we are taking En and all other elements are 0. So this is what a particular example of Schrödinger basis looks like in the case of LP. Similarly, you can define the case of, I think, LP in the case of 0, 2, pi, if you define set of all vectors, set of all finite dimensional vectors, this is a finite dimensional normed space with a basis, with a dimension P. In the case of 0, 2, pi, it's a periodic class of all functions which is defined with a suitable norm. Okay, in this case, I think actually you can define a shorter basis which is of the form, I think, 1 cos x sin x cos 2x sin 2x, etc. Okay, so this is actually E1, this is actually E2, this is actually E3, etc. This similar, you can define a shorter basis of such, because every element in 0, 2, pi can be expressed in terms of continuous function, can be expressed in the same terms of a Fourier series. The Fourier series consists of the terms 1 cos x, sin x, cos 2x, sin 2x, etc. So such a basis can be expressed in the case of LP 0, 2, pi as well. So this is actually a possible thing. So this is actually what do you mean by a shorter basis. So such an analysis may not be work in the case of our usual basis, but because the cos x and sin x may not be looking alike a linearly independent set, because when x is equal to 0, sine x is 0. Okay, when x is equal to 0, cos x may not be equal to 0. So for different values of x, this does not form the usual basis in the case of usual basis definition. But in the case of our analysis, this is an essential thing which can be used to analyze functions in the LP spaces. Okay, so this is what this is why we define the concept of shorter basis. Okay, so actually, which means that every element in the space can be expressed as a series sum, or every element in the space can be approximated using a series. Such a series, if at all it exists with respect to a certain class of vectors, then we can call that class of vectors as shorter basis. So this is what some elementary things about shorter basis. So from that concept of shorter basis, actually we can look into some properties of the metric space in general. So the first elementary property, which I think it is easy to prove for you all. So the property is that if a normed space X has a shorter basis, then X is separable. This is actually a trivial consequence of the shorter basis, because we have defined a shorter basis to be a class of elements En such that its summation j is equal to 1 to infinity alpha j Ej converges to X, or approximated to X for every X element of X. And also this En is actually a countable set. Okay, so it is E1, E2, E3, etc. It's actually a countable set. So we can approximate every element of this normed space using a countable set, which clearly indicates that this collection of sets, this collection of elements En, is actually dense in capital X, because we have already established that for every x in X, the space Ej to be a shorter basis, then norm of X minus summation j is equal to 1 to n alpha j Ej go to 0 as n tends to infinity, because which means that the difference of this is as small as possible. So in the neighbor of this point, in the neighborhood of this point, this series exists, or a linear combination of the elements of the space formed by this countable set exists. So if you take M as the collection En, then we can clearly say that M closure is equal to X. Since M is countable, we have a countable dense subset of all our normed space, which trivially indicates that our space is separable. Okay, so it's a trivial consequence that if a normed space has a shorter basis, then it can be separable. But in reverse part may not be true. Okay, so the reverse part is, if X is separable, for every separable space there should exist a shorter basis. That part need not be work. Actually, there are spaces which are separable which does not contain any shorter basis at all. So what the thing which we can say trivially is that if a space has a shorter base, then it's separable. Its converse part may not be true. So this is the thing about shorter basis. I hope you prove this statement. This is an exercise for you all. So thank you.